Get out of the whining web by addressing the process instead of the issue. Hi everyone, I'm BJ Muir from JesusHelpMeParent.com, and I teach families just like yours to use a heart-based approach to parenting. So if you want practical parenting solutions that develop real and lasting heart change in your kids and family, click that subscribe button right now. It's easy to get caught in the whining web. Your kid wanted permission to do something and you said no. But instead of accepting your no response, your kid began to whine or complain or even ask why. Before you knew it, you were 15 minutes deep into a discussion trying to explain your answer and only getting more frustrated by your kid's refusal to accept your initial answer of no. By the end of it, you may have even felt confused or guilty for saying no. And in the end, you feel trapped by what I tend to call the whining web because we get all tangled up. There are times in life when we do answer the why questions our kids have, but there are also lots of times where we choose not to. Obedience, or as I prefer to call it, cooperation, is not dependent on receiving the answer to the why question. Cooperation is expected because of the status we each hold in the parent-child relationship. Getting this correct now contributes to positive family culture while also helping your child in relationships with peers, teachers, future employers, and even Jesus. When your child continues to whine, complain, and ask why when they receive a no response, your child is telling you that he values the thing you're saying no to more than the relationship. That's what we need to change. To do this, we need to shift and start dealing with the process rather than the issue. One way to deal with the process rather than the issue is to start raising your child's awareness to the process itself. When your child begins to whine or complain, you can simply respond back with something like, "I've already answered that question. It's time for you to cooperate." Or something like, "You've already asked that question and received a response." This helps them become aware of the fact that they're not cooperating. Another way to deal with the process rather than the issue is to teach your child the correct way to respond when he receives a no answer. Know when you're going to be teaching your child this skill. You want to make sure it's not in the middle of the conflict, but rather at some other calm time in family life. You sit down with your child and explain to him the type of response you see him having whenever he gets told no. You will also want to help your child see how this lack of cooperation and obedience is negatively impacting his relationship with you. That's when you show that kid how you do want him to respond and how you do want him to follow through with action, and let him know there's going to be a chance, an opportunity for him to use this new skill pretty soon. A child who is whining about a no answer does not need more reasons why no is the answer. He needs to understand that when a parent says no, the best response is okay, mom, or okay, dad, even when it's hard. The fastest route to a future yes is not through whining now. It's through accepting no now. Philippians 2 verse 14 says, "Do everything without complaining or arguing." Parents who spend time focusing on the process and not just the issue end up having kids who make a heart change and who start responding differently. But if you don't think you've got time to work on the process, you're going to find yourself spending all that time you think you're saving dealing with the issue over and over and over again. So take the time now and invest in the process. You'll be glad you did. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and remember to follow Jesus Help Me Parent on Facebook and Instagram for daily parenting tips, strategies, and inspiration to parent using a heart-based approach to parenting. Thanks so much for listening, and I'll talk to you soon.